conference to come to?
So the San Antonio Breast Cancer Symposium is an important conference because it brings together all the people around the world who really care about breast cancer treatment. It began as a very small conference, and people, the fellows often ask, why is it in San Antonio? And the answer is that there was a group of investigators at the University of Texas at San Antonio that were amongst the first to look at estrogen receptor and other biomarkers in breast cancers. And they started this relatively small symposium about 30 years ago, and now it attracts, 15, 20,000 people a year. And it's great because if you're deep into breast cancer, it has the scientists, the clinicians, the surgeons, the radiation therapists, everybody together, and it really allows you to get some great ideas, meet the people who are in the field, and hear some exciting data and talks. So one of the most interesting presentations I attended today was sort of a breakout moment for a new class of therapeutics in breast cancer. You've heard a lot about immunological therapies in a variety of different cancers, melanoma, bladder cell carcinoma, non-small cell lung cancer. Breast cancer has been late to this party, and one of the first studies that we saw was of a Merck product, pembrolizumab, which is one of these checkpoint inhibitors that immunomodulates the host immune response. And in a study of triple negative breast cancer patients, a small study admittedly, but in a study of triple negative breast cancers, they saw that about 20% of patients had a clinical response to this therapy. There are side effects. You get the familiar now immunologic side effects of endocrinopathies and colitis and other problems. But we've been looking for decades for a way to crack open triple negative breast cancer. We've been relying on chemotherapy. So far, it has not dramatically changed the natural history of that disease in 20 years. And so this is a very exciting foot in the door for a new mode of therapy for triple negative breast cancer.
Okay.
So probably what I'm most interested in seeing the final data for at this year's meeting are the studies looking at the role of ovarian suppression in the management of early stage breast cancer. We've been using ovarian suppression as a way to control breast cancer for over 100 years. In fact, it was one of the very first treatments that we could offer women who had advanced breast cancer back in the 1890s. Just for the record, I was not there to administer that. But there's been a lot of question over the years as to whether or not ovarian suppression on top of our other treatments like tamoxifen or chemotherapy would be clinically valuable. And it's been surprisingly difficult to do these studies because the women who are younger tend to get chemotherapy, and that can often render a patient postmenopausal. So we are looking forward to the first data looking at the so-called SOFT trial, which is a study of ovarian function suppression. Women got tamoxifen by itself or tamoxifen with ovarian suppression. Now the interesting thing is that study ended up accruing two very different cohorts of women. There's a very low risk group of women who got no chemotherapy. And then there's a high-risk group of women who were younger, had more aggressive tumors, and they got chemotherapy but were still premenopausal. And what I'm looking to see is how different those two subgroups of patients look when it comes to analyzing the role of ovarian suppression.